Welcome back students. Today we are going to discuss a program based on decision making statements. So this is a board exam question asked in your previous year. So this is a question. Define a class electricity bill with the following specification. So class name is electricity bill, then instance variable or data members. So as you all know, instance variables are variables declared inside a class, that is known as instance variable. So here there are three instance variables are there, that is string n. This is used to store the name of the customer, then int units to store the number of units consumed, then double bill to store amount to be paid. So next one is the member methods. The first member method is void accept, to accept the name of the customer and the number of units consumed. So the next method is void calculate, to calculate the bill as per the following tariff. So this is the condition: number of units, rate per unit. First 100 units, the rate is rupees 2. Next 200 units, 3 rupees. Above 300 units, 5 rupees. A surcharge of 2.5% charged if the number of units consumed is above 300 units. So these are the things to be found in void calculate. Next one, void print method, to print the details as follows: name of the customer, number of units consumed, bill amount. Write a main method to create an object of the class and call the above member functions. So this is a question. So this is a 15 mark question. So here in this particular program, we are not specifying about the default constructor, isn't it? It's a constructor program, but here we are not specifying any constructors. It's a program for creating an object, and by using the object we want to invoke the member functions or member methods. So let's see. So in the question itself, they have given the variables to be declared, that is n to store the name of the customer, then units to store the number of units consumed, then bill to store the amount of bill to be paid. So let's declare all these things in the beginning of the program. So here we are using the accept method, that is this is similar to input, isn't it? So what are the things to be inputted? That is the name of the customer and number of units consumed. So these are the things to be entered by the user. So you can use scanner class or IO class for all these things. So when we start this program, you should import the package. So you can use scanner class or IO class. So here we are using the scanner class. So let's see the program. So the package is import java.util.scanner. And after that, put a semicolon and give the comment as package. Then class electricity bill. So the name of the class is given as electricity bill. Give the same name over here. So don't declare class electricity something like that or class bill something like that. Give the same name as given in the question paper. Okay, class electricity. The name of the class is electricity bill. Then opening of class. So here, the opening stage itself, here we are declaring our variables, instance variables. So instance variables are variables declared inside the class. So we want to declare three variables, that is n, units, bill. So string n, this particular variable is to store the name of the customer, int units, that is number of units consumed, then double bill, the amount to be paid. So these are the variables. So, and also we declare the data type also. So declare our first method. So all of you know how to declare a method. That is, here since these methods are not returning any value, so void accept. So the same thing given in the question paper itself, isn't it? So void accept. So what are the things to be accepted? That is, to accept the name of the customer and number of units consumed. So these are the two things to be received through keyboard by the user. So after this method, give the open brace, then declare our scanner class statement, that is scanner sc equal new scanner of system.in. So after that we have declared our first prompting message, that is system.out.println, enter the name of the customer. So we are going to store the name of the customer in the variable n. So we know that it's of string type, so n equal sc dot nestline of, that is by using the scanner class method nestline of, we declare our value, whatever value we received through the keyboard, that is stored in the variable n. Okay, next one is we want to receive the number of units consumed. Give the message or prompting message, that is system.out.println, enter the number of units consumed. So it is stored in the variable units, that is in the nest line units equal sc dot nestint of. So the data type of units variable is integer, so nestint of method is used here. So you can know that this is a method, so there is no space between the nestint method as that of nest line of. Here I should be in capital letter. Then close the accept method. Then we have to declare our next method, that is calculate. So void calculate of, open the method. So this program is not that much easy. We have already discussed all these type of questions. So here it's given that for the first 100 units, for the first 100 units, that is from 0 to 100. That is the meaning 0 to 100 units, rate per unit is rupees 2. That is for per unit we want to pay, suppose we are using 1 unit, we want to pay 2 rupees. Suppose we are using 2 units, we want to pay 2 into 2, that is 4. Suppose we are using 50 units, then 50 into 2, that is a rate per unit. For per unit, this is for 100 units, for per unit the rate is for the first 100 units. Next one is for next 200 units. Next 200 means already we have calculated for first 100 units. This next one is we want to calculate for next 200. That means 100 plus 20. That is up to 300. From how much? That is from 101 to 200. Isn't it? That is the thing. From 101 to, that is greater than 100 and less than 200, less than or equal to 200, that is the criteria. So if that is suppose we are using 150 units, so for that per unit the amount is rupees 3. Okay, next one is above 300. Above 300 means already we know first, for first 100 units the rate is 2, for next 200 is rate is 3. For above 300 means, that is, what is it? Above 300, the unit is per unit, we want to pay rupees 5. That is, here one more thing is given, a surcharge of 2.5% charged if the number of units consumed is above 300. So if you are consuming above 300 units, so instead of the bill amount, we want to pay a surcharge. That is, a 2.5% of bill amount is to be paid along with the bill amount. Clear? So this is the condition. So these are the things to be checked. That is, for first 100 units, 2 rupees per unit. Then next 200, rupees 3 per unit. Above 300, rupees 5 per unit. So let's see how to do all these things in the calculate function. So since there are multiple conditions are to be checked, we can use if, else if, else ladder. So since there are three conditions are there, so our first condition is if units less than or equal to 100, that is the units is from 0 to 100, that is the meaning, isn't it? Since it is an integer value, it's from 0 to 100, that is the thing we want to calculate. If the units is less than or equal to 100, so the bill amount equal to, bill equal 2 into units, 2 per unit, that is whatever units we are consuming, that into 2, that is our bill amount. Okay, if our units, we are suppose just consider if a user entering the units as 50, then it comes under this condition, isn't it? So what is the bill? Bill equal 2 into 50. Okay, So if this condition is false, we want to move on to the second criteria. So what is our criteria? For first 100, we know that the criteria is rupees 2 per unit. Next condition is for next 200. Next 200 means from 100, that is greater than 100 and less than or equal to 300. Next 200. 200 means 100 plus 200, that is 300. Isn't it? That is the thing we want to check. That is for next 200. Already we calculated for 100 units, isn't it? It's bill equal 2 into units. That is 100 into 2, whatever the amount may be. Okay. Else if, so the next condition is for next 200. So we want to check over there. We want to, this is not given in the question. So these all things you have to kept in mind, and these are the conditions to be checked for the second criteria. That is for next 200 means we want to calculate from greater than 100 and less than or equal to 300. That is the criteria. That is for next 200 means from 100 plus 200, that is 300. Okay, I hope it's clear for you. That is for that bill, that is the criteria is else if units greater than 100. This is the first thing. Already we calculated for 100 units, then greater than 100. That is from 101, isn't it? And units less than or equal to 300. That is units less than or equal to 300. So this is the condition for the next 200 units. Okay. So at that time bill equal 2 into, already we have calculated for 100 units. So for 100 units, what is the amount? For first 100 units, the bill amount is 2, right? That is 2 into 100. Rate is for per unit. So since it is 100 unit, 100 into 2 plus. So what is the next 200 means? Suppose already we suppose just consider if we are giving the bill amount as 200. Okay, already we calculated for 100. That's we written over here. For next, that is what is the remaining thing? That is 100 minus 200 minus 100, isn't it? That is units. What are the units? 200 minus 100. That is the thing over here. Okay, one bracket give units minus 100. For the next 200, what is the bill amount per unit into 3? 3 per unit. So I hope it's clear for you. So you people have to do dry run for this, then it will be more clear for you. Okay. Clear. Else, what is the thing? Above 300 means whatever the amount that comes, that should be more than 300. So give else. Okay. So on that case, what is the bill amount? Bill equal, so for first 100 units, we know 2 into 100, that is the bill amount. Plus for the next 200, 3 into 200. Plus for amount greater than 300 means, for next 300 means, that is whatever unit you are entering, that minus 300 into 5. Okay students, I hope it's clear for you. Suppose you are entering the bill amount, unit consumed as 400. Okay, so in that case, 400. Okay, clear. For first 100. We know per unit the amount is 2. So 2 into 100, that's we already know. Plus for the next 200 also, that is up to 300 we have calculated. That is 3 into 200 for next 200. 3 into 200 plus. So already we know for 300 units. For what is the next thing? We want to calculate for the remaining 100. So how we will calculate? Already we know for 300, that is, so if you are entering the unit of 400, that is unit is 400, that is units 400 minus 300, that is 100. 100 into 5, that is to be calculated. If the unit entered is 400, in that situation this condition will be matches, isn't it? So the bill amount is goes like this. Okay, units minus 300 into 5. Also one more thing given in the question, that is if the units consumed is greater than 300, then a surcharge of 2.5% of bill also be paid by the customer, isn't it? So we can declare the same thing in the bill variable itself. That is bill equal bill, whatever the bill may be, that bill plus 2.5% of bill amount, that is 2.5 into bill by 100. That is a surcharge. Surcharge 2.5%. That is calculated here. Clear, students? Okay. Then close the calculator method. Okay, after that, the next one is print method. So void print off. So in that we want to print all the things. So what is the first thing? System.out.println name of the customer. So what are printing statement given in the question paper? Give the same statement over here. Name of the customer. It's stored in the variable n plus n. Then system.out.println. Then number of units consumed plus units. Then system.out.println bill amount plus bill. Then close it. So print method is finished. Okay. So our all methods are finished. So next we want to declare our main method, that is public static void main string of arguments. Open the main method. Here we want to create a object of the class electricity bill. Electricity bill obj equal new electricity bill of. So we created a object. So by using this object we are calling our all methods. That is object name dot method name. That is obj dot first method is accept of. Then when we call this function, the controller will go to accept method. Whatever things executed that will be encountered. Okay, then obj dot calculate of obj dot print of. Then call close the main, close the class. So this is a program. So I hope you get the idea of this question. So in the board exam, in the case of this type of questions, in the if else if ladder, the question may becomes like this. Okay. The criteria will be like this. So study the post. Already we discussed this type of questions. Okay. So go through the questions and study all the particular things very clear. Okay. So let's see the output. That is enter the name of the customer. So this is the first message appeared. That is, and here we given it as Anu. Next message will appear. Enter the number of units consumed. Just consider here we have given 310. So since the criteria, what is the criteria? The amount consumed is, unit consumed is 310, isn't it? So in which criteria it comes? Since the unit is greater than 300, first the it will check this condition. That is, since our criteria is, what is the unit? 310. 310 less than or equal to 100. So it, this condition violates. Next we go to this condition. Units greater than 300, so 100, and units less than or equal to, this also violates. Then we come to the else part. That is units greater than 300. So whatever comes greater than 300, that will goes to the else part. So what we will calculate? Bill equal 2 into 100 plus 3 plus 200 plus units minus 300 into 5. So what is the units? What already we know for 300, up to 300 we know. That is 2 into 100, 400, first 100, it is 2 into 100, next 200, 3 into 200, for remaining things above 300. That is units, what is the units? 310 minus 10, that is 10 into 5. So this is the thing. Then we will calculate, since the amount is greater than 300, we want to calculate the surcharge also. That is to be added with the bill and we stored in the bill itself. Okay. So this is the thing happens over here. So this is the output, name of the customer Anu. After giving the enter key over here, we will get the output, name of the customer Anu. Name of the units consumed 310. Then bill amount 871.25. Okay. So the data description of the particular program is this. So already all these things given in the question itself. N units bill. Only the is where three variables are used in this program. N of string type, units of int type, bill of double type, and their purpose. So while writing a program, don't forget to write the comments. Okay, and also the data description table, and write the program correctly. Without writing the program logic correctly, we won't execute the program. So write the program logic correctly and write the program neatly. So I hope you got the idea of this. So let's continue with a new topic in the next class. Thank you.